Now I'll show you some of the Survalent ADMS applications that the operators and dispatchers can use in the control room using SmartVU. So this is how a typical control room display would look like. So one operator or dispatcher might have multiple monitors working for him, where they would put a different piece of information that they want to see on each monitor. So up here is a typical display which they might have, which would be the entire network in their GIS, which will allow them to see what's energized and de-energized by having different colors available. And also when it's energized, you'll be able to see exactly which feeder it belongs to based on the color code. So as you can see here, this orange section here belongs to this orange substation, and so on. Or you can either have it colored by feeder voltage levels instead. So in here, we'd be able to see exactly where the current outages are inside of the network. And they're color-coded as well to let you know what type of outage it is as well. So in here, I can show the outage later. So I can see, based on the color code, what type of outage it is. So I can see over here, there's 281 customers out. So if an operator or dispatcher clicks on the pushpin, they'll be able to see some key outage information about that particular outage case. So they'll be able to see how many customers are affected and how many are remaining. If there was a cause already set for the outage, do people know what the estimated time of restoration is for it? And if there's any messages for public that the utility is sharing at the moment, such as whether the crew has been dispatched or so on. If the operator or dispatcher wanted to see more detailed outage information, they can always right-click on the pushpin and click on Show Outage Case to see more details about that particular outage case. We also have the ability to also be able to see all the outage statistics available. This is all available in the OMS dashboard, but any of those KPIs or key performance indicators that you're using in the dashboard, you can set up as control panels inside of SmartVU. So if the operator or dispatcher wants to quickly see what is the key outage data that they're looking for, they can have that set up however they like and customize it here directly inside of SmartVU. So to get more detailed information about a particular KPI, such as the outages, so here I can see how many feeders currently have an outage, how many transformers are currently out, how many active outages I have, and what's my total loss KVA as well. Another key component for operators and dispatchers is to be able to see the everything inside of the substation. So they can draw single line diagrams inside of the SmartVU using the editor tool. So inside the substation, you can, whenever you actually issue a control there, whether it's telemetry or a manually set point, you can click on any of the breakers or devices inside of there and issue an open command. Once you go ahead and execute it, you'll actually see the topology processor update your line sections for you. I can hover over with my line section to see exactly what's the station feeder, substation feeder for a particular line section. In addition to that, inside the substation, you'll also be able to show any type of values that you're getting from the field as well. So for example, for this feeder here, if they wanted to show what's the current on the three different phases, they can set that up right next to the feeder, in addition to the megawatts, the MVA, or the MVARs for the particular feeder as well. If they actually want to see what's the history of a particular point inside of the substation, they can always just get a quick graph of the available data. So I can quickly see what's currently happening in a particular substation. If I want to compare points, I can simply just drag and drop an additional point into the graph. Another popular feature for the control room is using the control panels that allows them to mimic a faceplate that you actually see out in the field. So for example, if they have one of these meters set up out in the field, they'd actually be able to mimic that inside of SmartVU and actually see the exact same things it'd be if they were actually looking at that faceplate inside of the substation. So for example, if they wanted to cycle between any of these screens, it would be the same thing like they were actually pushing the button out in the field if the device supports this type of telemetry. So that's it. If you're interested in learning more about how Survalent can help you with some of these applications, please contact Survalent.